Okay, so we just looked at a way of modifying a document using the save method. Now let's look at an alternative way of updating documents. What I want to introduce you to here are two things. One, the update command, or method. In PyMongo, it's a method on collection objects. And the set operator. Let's talk about update first. Update expects a query document as its first parameter. And then as its second parameter, it expects an update document. And that update document specifies what operations MongoDB should perform on the document matching this query. Now, by default, update operates on just one document, the first one it finds matching the query document. The semantics of set are, if this document does not already contain the field specified here, then what should happen is that field should be added with this value. If the document already contains this field, then that field will be updated to the value supplied. Okay, now before I run this code, what I'd like to do is introduce you to the inverse operator for set, which is unset. Okay, so these two pieces of code are almost exactly the same. The only differences are here and here. The semantics of unset are, for whatever document matches this query, if it has the field specified here, remove it. This value is ignored. Now, if this document does not already have this field, then this call has no effect. Okay, so now we've looked at the set operator and the unset operator and their use with the update command. Now, let's go and run these two programs and see what their effect is. But first, I want to query for this document in the Mongo shell to look at its current state. And then we can see how running those two programs changes its state. So I'm going to run a find one command here. Now, this is exactly the same command as we saw in the Python programs we were looking at. The only difference is in the name. And the names are different merely to match the conventions of the two different programming languages represented. In this case, JavaScript, because the language of the Mongo shell is JavaScript. And in the other case, Python, because we're using the PyMongo driver. Okay, so I'm going to issue this query. And I want to point out that the ISO code is in fact present. Now let's run the unset example. And then go back to the Mongo shell and issue our query again. Okay, and note that the ISO country code has disappeared because we just ran this command. Okay, now let's run our set example. And again, remember, this simply uses the set operator. We'll issue our query again in the Mongo shell. And note that the ISO country code is now in our document again. Okay, so now we've looked at two different commands that allow us to modify documents. The save command and the update command. And we've looked at two different operators being used in conjunction with the update command. Okay, now I feel like it's necessary before we move on to just give you a heads up. It's really easy to forget to put an operator here. Okay? If you issue your command this way, what's going to happen is this entire document, the document matching this query, will be replaced so that it contains the underscore ID field and this field only. So essentially, the document will be composed entirely of a single field. So always take care to use update correctly.